إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. I announced that we going to take some points from the Friday khutbah given by فضيلة الشيخ العالم الشيخ محمد بن أحمد الفيفي. But I decided not to make any interpretation or take any points from that lecture. So I don't fell short in interpreting it. So I may not give it, it is right. So that's not the topic I am, the khutbah I am interpreting tonight, inshallah. But the topic is about the same title, which was taqwa Allah. That's the only thing. And inshallah, maybe. طيب. The topic is taqwa Allah. What's the meaning of taqwa Allah? Taqwa Allah, who help us to have the right definition of taqwa Allah. Barakallahu fiqh. Some of the ulama said that taqwa Allah, which is so great, and Allah mentioned, He command the people in general and the believers especially to have taqwa in many ayat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a condition of the iman to have taqwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that what honors the person is taqwa Allah. People are honored based on how they have taqwa, not based on their lineage and the like. Taqwa Allah is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoined, what Allah command all the believers, from Prophet Adam to the last one. So it is so important. Allah mentioned that the best thing to take more from is taqwa Allah. Taqwa Allah is the cause someone to enter Jannah, paradise, and is the cause someone to be safe from hellfire. It is taqwa Allah. Nobody will be safe from hellfire except the one who acquired taqwa, taqwa Allah Azza wa Jal. And nobody will enter Jannah except the one who have taqwa. Is the one that taqwa Allah is what, if you have it, Allah give you provision in this worldly life and the hereafter, whether you know where this provision is coming or whether you don't know it. Taqwa Allah, based on how you have taqwa, is how Allah makes your matters easy. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes your matter easy. Through taqwa Allah, Allah give you a knowledge you never know. Irhamuk Allah. Allah increase you in knowledge by having taqwa Allah. Many ayat in Quran, many sound hadith about the importance of having taqwa. So what is the taqwa? If Allah command to have taqwa, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَقُوا اللَّهِ or you believe half taqwa. We never think that Allah command something He didn't make it clear. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibit something He didn't make it clear. So it's very important for us to know what's being commanded and what's being prohibited. If Allah forbade the shirk, everyone should know what shirk is. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command the tawheed, everyone should know what tawheed is. طيب تقوى الله, some of the ulama said, as akhuna mentioned, is امتثال أوامر الله واجتناب النواهي. To fulfill what Allah command and to avoid what Allah forbade. This is one definition. Some of the ulama said that taqwa Allah means to fulfill what Allah command and to avoid what Allah forbade. Whoever has this, he has taqwa Allah. And he gets all those rewards and much more in Quran and Sunnah. Another definition for taqwa Allah. Naam. بارك الله فيك. طيب let you have the definition of taqwa from some of the Sahaba, the companion of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and from some of the ulama. From Ali ibn Abi Talib رضي الله تعالى عنه said التقوى الخوف من الجليل والعمل بالتنزيل والقناعة بالقليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. These four things علي رضي الله تعالى عنه define تقوى الله. He said التقوى الخوف من الجليل. To fear from who? الجليل, the great. الجليل الله. جليل is one of the names of Allah. So it's to fear Allah. والعمل بالتنزيل, and to act upon the revelation. Number two. Fear of Allah with the application of the revelation. والقناعة بالقليل, and to be satisfied with the small. If Allah provides you عز وجل with a small provision, to be pleased with it. يرحمك الله. To be pleased with it. To be happy with it. يعني the truth, the person who has the correct taqwa is not the one who worships Allah عز وجل only in a state of ease and enlargement. But when he is his provision is strained, then he turned away. This is not someone who acquired the taqwa. So, وَالْقَنَاعَةُ بِالْقَلِيلِ. What is the qana'a? Yes? Be satisfied with the qalil, with the small. Whatever Allah provides you with, of course you take the means. وَالْإِسْتِعْدَادُ لِيَوْمِ الرَّحِيلِ. And to be ready, to get ready for the day of journey. The day of the death, to be prepared for the death. The one who has these four qualities, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, he has taqwa Allah. He fears Allah, he acts upon the revelation, he satisfied with the small, with whatever Allah provided with, and he prepared himself for the day of journey. Which is journey from worldly life to akhirah. Also from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said when he was making tafsir on the eye of Allah, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqati. Or you who believe have taqwa, haqqa tuqati. The correct taqwa. of Allah عز وجل. He said, it means أن يطاع فلا يعصى ويذكر فلا ينسى وأن يشكر فلا يكفر. عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه said, what means the taqwa Allah is to Allah to be obeyed and not to be disobeyed. Allah to be remembered and not to be forgot. And Allah to be thanked, not to be unthankful. To thank Allah Azza wa Jal and to be grateful to Him and not to be ungrateful. So to obey Allah, not to disobey, to remember Allah, not to forget, and to thank Allah, not to be unthankful a person. From also the great alim and a Muslim ruler, Umar bin Abdul Aziz, رحمه الله تعالى, said, this is Umar bin Abdul Aziz known. He is one of the most justest Muslim khulafa in the Muslim history. He was one of them, Umar bin Abdul Aziz, and he was from the great scholars of Medina. He was a alim scholar who teach people classes, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him to be the Muslim ruler. Imagine alim who become a Muslim ruler. Scholar who become the Muslim ruler, the leader of the Muslims. What do you think he will call people to? What do you think he will push people to apply? Not only the mandatories but also the sunnah. Umar bin Abdul Aziz, rahimahullah, he said, but he was only 2 years Muslim ruler. Only 2 years. But he changed those 2 years the life of the Muslims. Full of knowledge, justice. They say before him, people, they used to compete in some of the worldly matters. His time, people used to compete of the knowledge of the Sharia. Naam. Subhanallah. So he said, Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahimahullah, ليس تقوى الله بصيام النهار ولا بقيام الليل والتخليط فيما بين ذلك ولكن تقوى الله ترك ما حرم الله وأداء ما افترض الله فمن رزق بعد ذلك خيرا فهو خير إلى خير. He said, rahimahullah, ليس تقوى الله بصيام النهار ولا بقيام الليل. Taqwa Allah is not fasting the day and praying the night. والتخليط بين ذلك. والتخليط بين ذلك. والتخليط بين فيما بين ذلك. And between that, to make خلط, which means to mix good with bad. يعني to mix with this fasting of the day and praying of the night, also to do the sin. He said, taqwa Allah is not this. Someone, even though he is fasting the day, he is praying the night, the tahajjud, but yet he is committing a sin. He said, this is not taqwa Allah. His taqwa Allah, walakin taqwa Allah, but it is, taqwa Allah is, tarku ma haram Allah. To live of that which Allah prohibit. Wa ada'u ma aftarad Allah. To fulfill what Allah commanded. فَمَنْ رُزِقَ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ خَيْرًا. Whoever is guaranteed after that good, means optional ibadat, extra good, فَهُوَ خَيْرٌ إِلَى خَيْرٌ. It's a good with good. It's a extra. So, Umar bin Abdul Aziz, the Muslim Khalifa, rahimahullah, said, تَقْوَى اللَّهِ is not fasting the day and praying the night and mixing it with sin. Fasting the day and praying the night at tahajjud and mixing it with sin, committing sin also. Rather, it's just a living off, avoiding what Allah forbade, and fulfilling what Allah commanded. After that, whoever is given good, نعم, يعني this is good plus good. This alhamdulillah. So for instance, the one who fasts, the one who upon tawheed, and he just prayed the five prayers, and he fasts only Ramadan, he give only zakah, he only perform the mandatory hajj, and the like of the mandatories, and he avoid the sin. Even though he doesn't do a kistara ibadat of optional, he said this one has the taqwa. After that, if he is given to also have some optional acts of worship, of a kistara fasting, a kistara charity, a kistara hajj and the like, this is good with good. But taqwa Allah is to avoid the sin. This is what it means. To avoid the sin. Naam, this is taqwa Allah. So it's not how much act of worship person is doing it. Rather, is to fulfill the command and to avoid the prohibition. This is taqwa Allah. After that, alhamdulillah, if you struggle on the acts of worship, naam, this is more taqwa. But you have the foundation of it, and you get the reward of taqwa Allah by doing, by avoiding the haram and fulfilling the commands. Lastly, divination, we're going to mention from the ulama, is another divination that many ulama choose it. Is the divination of the tabi Talq bin Habib. He said, At-taqwa is the one Akhuna Hassan mentioned. He said, At-taqwa, أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله ترجو ثواب الله وأن تترك معصية الله على نور من الله تخشى عقاب الله. Some of the people of knowledge chose this to be the correct divination and more suitable divination of taqwa Allah because of having the conditions of. So he said, At-taqwa, أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله ترجو ثواب الله. Three conditions. وأن تترك معصية الله على نور من الله تخشى عقاب الله. Three conditions. التقوى, he said, أن تعمل بطاعة الله. To act upon the obedience of Allah. What Allah command you, you act upon it. على نور من الله, upon a knowledge from Allah. Upon a knowledge from Allah. So you have knowledge for that obedience. ترجو ثواب الله. Willing and seeking and expecting the reward of Allah. That's your intention. So to obey Allah by fulfilling what He command, while you are upon a knowledge that Allah command it, and you do it for Allah. On the other hand, he said, وَأَن تَتْرُكَ مَعْصِيَةَ اللَّهِ, to leave off the disobedience of Allah. عَلَى نُورٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ, while you are upon a knowledge from Allah, upon a light from Allah, means you have knowledge that this is sin. So you leave it off. It's not you leave off because people are leaving it. No, you have a knowledge, ala basira, that Allah forbade it. Therefore you left it. Why you left it? He said, takhsha iqab Allah, fearing of the punishment of Allah. So this is what some of the ulama choose to be taqwa Allah. At-taqwa, an ta'amala bita'ati Allah ala nuri min Allah. Some people, they do obey Allah. They are upon obedience, but they do not know. They don't have a knowledge for that disobedience of Allah Azza wa Jal. That this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoined. They don't know that. Some people, they live off the sin without knowing that this is a sin. They don't do it. They leave it. As some people leave something lawful, you can leave something lawful. If you want, you can leave drinking milk, for instance. Nothing is wrong with it. As long as you believe, it's permissible to drink the milk. If you leave eating that meat, which is lawful meat, you don't eat it. So, some people, they leave the same thing, they leave the sin, some sin, while they don't know it is a sin. This person, he leaves the sin because he has a knowledge from Allah that this is a sin. Number two, he does that for the sake of Allah. Not to exercise, not to show off. He does that for the sake of Allah. So if it's obeying Allah, he does that to have hope in Allah's reward. While he has hope in Allah's reward. And if he leaves off the sin, he does that because of fear of Allah. Fear of the punishment of the sin. So, taqwa Allah Azza wa Jal is to obey Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. To obey Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala mentioned in His Quran many ayat, He commands to have taqwa. He said, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, ittaqu Allah. Or you who believe, have taqwa. Have taqwa. Obey Allah Azza wa Jal. Obey Allah Azza wa Jal by fulfilling what He commands, avoiding what He forbids. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ And die not except while you are a Muslim. Allah said in another ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا Or you believe half taqwa Allah and speak the truth. When you speak and say the truth. Not lie. So this is from taqwa, farming taqwa. When the person is speaking, he says the truth. He doesn't lie. And Allah said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqwa Allah wa kunu ma'a sadiqeen. Or you who believe, have taqwa Allah and be with the truthful ones, not with the liars. Allah said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu taqwa Allah wal tanzur nafsun ma qaddamat li ghadin wa taqwa Allah. This is Surah Al-Hashr, this ayah, verse 18. Surah Al-Hashr. As for the first ayah, somebody wants the number of the verse. First ayah, يُلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِي وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ Surah Al-Imran 102. The second ayah, يُلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَقُوا اللَّهَ وَقُولُوا قَوْلًا سَدِيدًا Surah Al-Ahzab 70. The third ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَقُوا اللَّهَ وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ Surah At-Tawbah 119. And this verse, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ Surah Al-Hashr, verse 18. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Surah Al-Hashr, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا تَقُوا اللَّهَ Or you who believe, fear Allah and keep your duty to Him. Fear Allah and keep your duty to Him. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدْ And let every person look to what he has sent forth for tomorrow. For tomorrow. For tomorrow or for tomorrow. For tomorrow, barakallahu fiikum. Wattaqu Allah and fear Allah. Inna Allah khabirun bima ta'malun. Verily Allah is well acquainted with what you do. So in this ayah, Allah command to have taqwa. From the taqwa, wal tanzur nafsun ma qaddamat li ghad. And let every person look to what he has sent forth for tomorrow. Yani. Tomorrow here means يعني the day of judgment. يعني person to look at, for instance, if you die now, what are you expecting? What did you do of good? you expecting good from it. Whether you did it of sin, you fear from it is evil consequence. So you need to make repentance from it now. And the like. How about if you die now? Are there other people who have debt on you? يعني ونفس المؤمن معلقة بدينه. Even the good Muslim who deserve rahma in the grave will not have it until the debt is paid off. So from taqwa Allah, the Muslim to look, do you have right? Does anyone have right on you? So if you die now, then this is not fulfilling taqwa Allah. وَلْتَنْظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Have taqwa Allah, fear Allah and be dutiful to Him if you are believers. If you are truly believers, have taqwa. Obey Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah said in Surah An-Nisa, وَلَقَدْ وَصَيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنْ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. This Surah An-Nisa, what verse number? Here it says, if the printer wrote down here 13, it's not right. 131, so the one is cut off, okay. Jazakallah, 131. Here I have 13. This I is somewhere in there. 131, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Azza wa Jal, you say 131? Oh, it's in the middle, okay. I saw the beginning of the ayah. وَلِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And in this ayah of Surah An-Nisa 131, and to Allah belongs all that is in the heavens and all that is in the earth. And verily, we have recommended to the people of the scripture before you and to you, O Muslims, that you all fear Allah and keep your duty to Him. So this is what Allah recommended all the people, to all people, to the previous nations and to this ummah, everyone. This is from the act of worship that Allah legislates for all the believers. It is known that there are some acts of worship Allah didn't legislate for some of the believers, for some of the prophets. But this one, to have taqwa, is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recommended to all people. Another ayah in Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah said, even to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُطِعِ الْكَافِرِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقِينَ. O you Prophet, have taqwa and do not obey the disbelievers and hypocrites. Don't obey them, means in sin, not in good. Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he had agreement with them, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam obeyed them in some things. So this is still what has been commanded. So Allah commanded the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to have taqwa. Sheikh Salih al-Sheikh Hafidhullah, he said, if a command is given, when Allah gives a command, Allah commands something to someone, people, they vary, they different. Sometimes Allah command someone who didn't have it, who doesn't have it. For instance, some Allah command the disbelievers to believe. They don't have belief by that time. So here means have it. If Allah command someone who has it but it's not complete, if Allah command means completed. Someone who is a believer, Allah command to have, to believe means increase more. Na'am, he said if Allah command someone what he has already, As Allah commanded the Prophet ﷺ to have taqwa Allah, means be firm. Be on that path. So if you see the ayah, Allah commanded the Prophet ﷺ to have taqwa Allah, it doesn't mean that Prophet ﷺ didn't have by that time. He had it, alayhi sallam, the best taqwa. But it means keep firm. Have that taqwa. Al-Muhim, the point is Allah Azza wa Jal, He commanded even Prophet Muhammad to have taqwa, to obey Allah Azza wa Jal. And from that, from taqwa Allah, not to obey the disbelievers and the munafiqoon, because they're calling you to sin. The kuffar, they're calling you to sin. They're calling you to shirk. They're calling you to disobey Allah. Don't obey them. Likewise, the hypocrites, those who say they're Muslims, but truly they are not Muslims. Because of... So don't obey them. Don't obey anyone calling you to sin. وَلَا تُطِعْ مِنْهُمْ آثِمًا أَوْ كَفُورًا وَلَا تُطِعْ مِنْهُمْ آثِمًا أَوْ كَفُورًا So don't obey ithm and kufr. Don't obey anyone who calling you to sin or calling you to kufr. The two types of the sin, the major one, the minor. Anyone who calling you to one of that, don't obey. That's from taqwa Allah. Someone say, let we smoke. You don't smoke, that means you have taqwa Allah. But that's when you're doing it for Allah. Naam. Someone call you to oppress someone, to steal, to do this, you refuse. Because you know you are upon knowledge, this is not allowed in Islam, and you are doing this because you fear Allah. Then you have taqwa Allah. And taqwa Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 197, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ Increase means acquire more, because the best of the zad, the best thing to increase is taqwa Allah. The best thing someone to increase is not to have more money, it's not to have more wealth, rather is to have more taqwa, more obedience to Allah. This is the best thing. Allah said, وَاتَّقُونِ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ Have taqwa, fear of me, O أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ أي أُولُو الْعُقُولِ وَالْأَحْلَامِ O those who have intellect and understanding. And on the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blame those who don't have taqwa. In verse Surah Al-Baqarah 206, Allah blame and condemn those who don't have taqwa. 206 in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ أَخَذَتُ الْعِزَّةُ بِالْإِثْمِ فَحَسْبُهُ جَهَنَّمْ وَلَا بِئْسَ الْمِهَادِ And when it is said to him, it's a type of a people, when they are said to him, to them, fear Allah, he is led by arrogance to more crime. Someone, when he said to fear Allah, someone doing wrong, somebody tell him, fear Allah, don't do this, fear Allah, don't say this, he got offended. And the arrogance and the rejection of the truth leads him to do more sin. Allah said, فَحَسْبُهُ جَهَنَّمْ So enough for him is hell. This one, who his quality is, this is his way of life. When he is called to fear Allah, to obey Allah, by just saying this to him, it leads him to commit more crime. That what suffices him enough for him is hell. Allah said, وَلَا بِئْسَ الْمِهَادِ And worst indeed is that place to rest. عِيَادًا بِاللَّهِ The worst place to rest is what? Is hell. is fire. الله سأل إن سورة الحجرات إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. Indeed, the most honorable among you with Allah is the one who has more taqwa. Someone seeking to be honored, Allahu Akbar. To be honored, to have taqwa. Did you ever went to a leaders, one of the kings or the leaders, place, house, and when people are in long line to be being checked up and filling application, you, because you're very special, you just go another place. They take you from another way, no checkup. How you going to feel? In an airport, when all of us, we are in a long line, there are some people who have their own airport. They're already at home. And you were there 3 hours. Even they don't have ID, some of them. You see that? When the soldiers or those who are there see them, they honor them. He move. They may even carry his shoes. Allah al-Musta'an. Al-Muhim. The point is, subhanallah, the real honor and the real honor with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the real honor one at the side of Allah is the one who obeys Allah. Even people, if people humiliate you, they disrespect you, they don't marry you when you're looking for a marriage, when you want someone to intercede for you, don't find anyone make intercession for you because you have no respect in the society. But if you have taqwa, you are on the top of them. And they will know one day. They will know one day. إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Therefore, Allah said, فَلَا تُزَكُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Don't what? Don't praise yourself. Don't praise yourself. You say good about yourself. Why? Because Allah is the one who knows the most who has taqwa. Because the taqwa is in the heart. التقوى ها هنا. Prophet Sallam ويشير إلى صدره ثلاث مرات. It's in the heart. But the fruit comes out. If the heart is sound, the statement, action must be sound. It must. It is impossible the heart to be sound and the statement and the actions to be bad. Impossible. لماذا؟ إن في الجسد مضغة إذا صالحت صالح الجسد كله. Indeed, in the body, there is a flesh. If it is sound, the rest of the body is going to be sound. Prophet Sallam said, ألا وهي القلب, it is the heart. So if you find someone praising himself, you know he doesn't have taqwa. Or it is small. It's weak. If you find someone praising himself, rather the more someone has taqwa, the more he humble himself. Wallahi, the more he humble himself. Therefore, you remember that great tabi'i, the biggest of the tabi'i, the one who Prophet ﷺ didn't meet with him, because he is tabi'i, but yet Prophet ﷺ said to Umar, if you meet with him, ask him to ask Allah for your forgiveness. Umar bin al-Khattab, Awais al-Qarni. When Umar said to this, what Awais al-Qarni said? Oh, the Messenger of Allah said that to you, Alhamdulillah, I am this. He didn't say. He said, you are Amir al-Mu'mini. You are Amir al-Mu'mini. You are Umar bin al-Khattab. Not only Umar bin al-Khattab, when Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu mentioned that to the people, that this is what Prophet ﷺ told him, because Umar, he was nasih radiallahu ta'ala anhu, sincere for the people. He wanted them to have what he had. A man look for this great tabi'i. Great tabi'i. And this one portion of the lot of miracles, Prophet ﷺ, that he was a prophet of Allah. How many things he mentioned, ﷺ, which will take place in the future, and each one of it took place, or is not yet, it's coming. This is one of it. Prophet, he named this man, his description, his lineage, his mother, his way of life. He mentioned to that ماذا to عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه. So one of them, one man find him. He said, you this, ask Allah for me subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me. He said, you come from the Hajj now. You come from the Hajj. Naam. All that to, yani, means he say you deserve to make dua for me, not you. Naam. So, al-muhim, the more someone has truly taqwa of Allah, is the more he humble himself. So if you find someone who wants to make himself higher, that's no taqwa. Even no taqwa or is weak. Naam. And don't think to humble yourself for the sake of Allah. Not for other reason. Don't ever think that that humiliates you or dishonors you. Rather, it lifts you up. As the Prophet ﷺ said, من تواضع لله رفع. Whoever humble himself for sake of Allah, Allah raises him. Raises him. And the opposite is true. The one who tried to raise himself نعم, in a wrong way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala humiliates him. Like those who are proud, they're proud of their lineage. And they say, my father is this, my grandfather is this. They're very proud. In the day of judgment, they're going to be worse than the al-ju'lan, that insect which moves the stool through his tongue, through his nose. There is a type of animal, amazing they say, of insect. If it smells perfume, it dies. If it smells what's in the bathroom, it likes. A'udhu billah. Now, subhanallah, many ayat in Quran in what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala command to have taqwa. From that, Allah said subhanah in Surah Al-Baqarah, at least in Surah Al-Baqarah, how many verses? More than 15 ayat. 15 commands of Allah to have taqwa. Fattaqu an-nar التي وقودها الناس والحجارة. Fear of fire, which it is fuel, is people, is man, and stones. نعوذ بالله منها. واتقوا يوما, fear of a day, is a day of judgment. لا تجزي نفس عن نفس شيئا. No soul will benefit you anything. وأتوا البيوت من أبوابها واتقوا الله. Have تقوى. One of the benefits of having taqwa, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, to succeed, to have success. This is one of the benefits of taqwa. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Another benefit of taqwa. Have taqwa and know that Allah is with those who have taqwa. Allah is with those who have taqwa. Those who obey Allah, Allah is with them, assisting them, helping them, protecting them. سبحان الله واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب. Have taqwa of Allah and know that the punishment of Allah is severe. نعم إن الله واعلموا أن الله شديد العقاب. Allah is with severe punishment. Jazakallahu khair. Yes, Jazakallahu khair. That's it. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْهِ تُحْشَرُونَ. Have taqwa Allah and know that you will be gathered to Him, to Allah. You will be gathered to Allah Azza wa Jal. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَاعْلَمُوا أَنَّكُمْ مُلَاقُوهُ. Fear Allah, have taqwa of Allah. Means obey Allah and know that you will meet Him. You will meet Him. واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله بكل شيء عليم. Have taqwa of Allah and know that Allah عز وجل بكل شيء عليم, knows everything. واتقوا الله واعلموا أن الله بما تعملون بصير. Have taqwa of Allah and know that Allah sees everything. sees everything. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وذروا ما بقي من الربا. Or you believe half taqwa of Allah and leave off what remain from the riba. Some people had a riba. They were still consuming riba, dealing with the usury or the riba. Was they called today interests? Allah command them to stop. يعني to leave off what remain from the riba means to stop the riba. Another Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. And fear of a day that you will be returned to Allah. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Have taqwa of Allah. وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. What does it mean? Yes. And Allah will teach you, and Allah will teach you. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Yes. Yes. Barakallahu feekum. But this is not right. Sheikh Saleh al-Sheikh Hafidhullah, he said, this ayah, many people they use as a proof, if you have taqwa of Allah, you get the knowledge. He said, that's true, the meaning, but this verse doesn't show that. Because Allah didn't say, Subhanahu, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَيُعَلِّمُ. So it's not connected to it. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ is separate. Have taqwa of Allah. وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah is teaching you. It's a istinaf, it's a beginning. Otherwise it would have been majzoom. You understand? But there are other verses showing that taqwa of Allah brings knowledge. All those verses were in Surah Al-Baqarah. Some of the verses in Surah Al-Imran, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُونَ. Prophet Isa said to his people, have taqwa of Allah and obey me. Prophet Isa alayhi salam. So all those verses وسورة البقرة سورة آل عمران many other verses at least 6 آيات سورة النساء also another آيات at least 3 or more سورة المائدة more than 10 also سورة الأنعام سورة الأنفال سورة التوبة سورة هود سورة الحجر سورة الحج سورة الشعراء سورة لقمان سورة ياسين سورة الزمر سورة الزخرف سورة الحجرات سورة الحديد سورة المجادلة سورة الحشر. All those verses Allah mentioned to have taqwa in a form of command. In a form of command. Otherwise, the verses about the taqwa, the virtue of taqwa, those who have taqwa are so much. So all those verses was half taqwa, half taqwa, half taqwa. It was not like the one who has taqwa get this. This is another form. And if we just look Surah Al-Talaq, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. And whosoever fears Allah and keeps his duty to him, he will make a way for him to get out, means from every difficulty. He will make a way from him to get out from every difficulty. This is one of the fruits of taqwa. You go through difficulty, your hardship, you fear your enemy, you encounter a danger, and then and you have taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jalla saves you from it. And if you talk to the people and they tell you their stories, real stories, people go through difficult and hardship and they ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make easy for them, you're surprised. One of the teachers of Quran one time told me that they had a money, a lot of money, which was not allowed to carry that number of money. And accidentally the police stopped people checking it in another country. And this was his money. And he was a Quranic teacher. He feared so much. And these people, even though the money is, they shouldn't carry, but those who are doing that are not the government, are not the police, I mistake. They are not the police. They are the robberies. And they were killing people, he said. They killed people before him. Some of them, they killed them on the spot, he see, when they got money from them. Some of them, they beat them. He said, when they were close to, he asked Allah, oh Allah, if you save me this. Oh Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they were close to him, reaching one person before him, police came. The police came and this, they run. They fight and they run. He said one person was before and they never didn't leave anyone. The one they get the money, they either kill him or they beat him with the taking the money. The one who doesn't have money, they don't trust him. They also get mad at him. They were robbery, criminals. So يعني it happened that if the someone asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah mentioned in the Quran, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah, who have taqwa, who obeys Allah, Allah will make a way for him to get out. And you remember the hadith, تعرف إلى الله في الرخاء يعرفك في الشدة. نعم, means obey Allah in the ease, he subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you in the difficulty. In the same surah, some of the benefit and fruits of taqwa, Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ قَالَ تَعَالَى وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And Allah will provide him, means the one who fears Allah, the one who obeys Allah, Allah will provide him from sources he never could imagine. The one who have taqwa and obeys Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that he will provide him from sources he never could imagine. Sometimes Allah provides you from where you're expecting. And sometimes from where you never imagined it. You never thought you can have some provision from this way. But Allah opened a way for you. How many people despair from the life and never expected they will have way out from what they are. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the gates for them. In the same ayah, Allah said, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُ إِنَّ اللَّهَ بَالِغُ أَمْرِهِ قَدْ جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدْرًا. Allah said in the same surah, ذَلِكَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ أَنْزَلَهُ إِلَيْكُمْ وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يُكَفِّرْ عَنْهُ سَيِّئَاتِ وَيُعْظِمْ لَهُ أَجْرًا. If there is no fruits for obeying Allah and having taqwa, other than this fruit, it's enough. It's the one who have taqwa, what he will get. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Azza wa Jal, no, before that ayah, the verse I was reading was verse number, the beginning was verse number two, verse number three. And this verse is number four. Allah said, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. All these ayat in the same surah. Which means, and whoever fears Allah and keeps his duty to him, he will make his matter easy for him. He will make his matter easy for him. Verse number five, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يُكَفِّرْ عَنْهُ سَيِّئَاتِ وَيُعْظِمْ لَهُ أَجْرًا. And whosoever fears Allah and keeps his duty to him, he will expiate for him his sins and will enlarge his reward. He will expiate for him from him his sin. يعني your sin will be forgiven by Allah. And the Shaykh Uthaymeen said, forgiving the sin means two things. covering the sin for you. Allah is not going to expose you to the creation, so they don't know you. Even though you have this weakness and evil and sin, Allah covers it. And also, you are not being punished. Naam, because of that sin. This means ghufran with them. Then Allah expiated your sin, forgave your sin. Allah said, وَيُعْذِمْ لَهُ أَجْرًا, and Allah will enlarge his reward, means the one who obeys him. So it's reminding for the believer, whenever we go through difficulty, this Salaf al-Salih, they used to check themselves. Whenever they go through difficulty, they say there has to be a problem from our side, because Allah said, وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَاذَا وَيَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ يُسْرًا. Whosoever fears Allah, Allah makes his matters easy. Is my matter is not easy, then I have to review myself. Because Allah doesn't break the promise. He said in Quran, وَأَوْفُوا بِعَهْدِي أُوفِي بِعَهْدِكُمْ. Fulfill my covenant, and I will fulfill your covenant. So never say, why I go through this difficult, and you blame عِيَادًا بِاللَّهِ Allah Azza wa Jalla. Blame yourself. Naam. Sometimes, yes, you go through difficult, not because you commit a sin, but because Allah to purify you, Allah to increase your level. But the ulama, they say the origin is that the difficult is because of our sin. That's the origin. And that's the most of the cases. Because of our shortcoming, that the difficult is our sin. But sometimes is not because of sin, but because of testing. And also because of رَفْعُ الدَّرَجَات, to raise the person levels. But the origin is that it is shortcoming. It is a punishment. So whenever the Muslim has a difficult, he should look what I did wrong. Therefore, subhanAllah, those good people who can count their sin, who can remember, they used to say when they disobey Allah, they used to feel that from their horses and their wives. They used to know that. The horse isn't even given hard time. The wives are giving them hard time. They know it when they do wrong. Naam. Naam. But if the sin is too much, it's a lot, you don't know where to start and where the problem is coming from. Naam. But they were those, we ask Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. اللهم إنا نسألك تقواك. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك, ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك, ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. ومتعنا اللهم بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقوتنا ما أحييتنا, واجعله الوارث منا, واجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا, وانصرنا على من عادانا, ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا, ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا. This دعاء as narrated Imam Tirmidhi in his Jami' from Abdullah ibn Umar, and the ulama like Sheikh al-Albani, they authenticated. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make this supplication for his companion mostly whenever he finished a gathering. قَلَّمَا يعني, it was very rare. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he finished a gathering, rather he used to make this dua. But it was not narrated to say Ameen out loud. يعني to say Ameen out loud or to raise hands. Wallahu a'lam. That needs a research. Wallahu a'lam. Wa sallallahu sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullaha wal tanzur nafsum ma qaddamat ligadin wattaqullaha inna allaha khabirun bima ta'amaloon. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة, أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله, وتلك الأمثال نضربها للناس لعلهم يتفكرون. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم